Welcome to LC Screen Talk. My name is Larry, and this is my review of Horrible Bosses 2. Surprise for me. I know everybody's really divisive on the first one. A lot of people, like me, thought it was way funnier than expected. And then there's a lot of people who just didn't get it and didn't like it. I can definitely understand both point of views, and I think Horrible Bosses 2 is probably going to be the same way because I actually really enjoyed it. Might even say I enjoyed it more than the first one, but I gotta revisit the original before I say that. I know a lot of people also aren't liking this one right off the bat, but let's go ahead and just dive right into the review, shall we? I'm going to start out by just talking about the cast and the characters that we get in this. So we have almost all of our original cast members back for this one. So our main trio of Jason Bateman, Jason Sudeikis, and Charlie Day are back. And they are as good as they were in the first one for sure. Charlie Day is the standout. But I think that he's a borderline positive, borderline negative standout, and here's why. He has the best comedic moments out of our three. He has some really, really funny stuff, and he's by far the most memorable out of almost any of the characters, but definitely the main three cast. But his character is so stupid and so grating that he comes off quite a bit annoying in a lot of the different parts of the movie. So his character just weaves in and out of being lovable and funny and hilarious to annoying and loud and just obnoxious. So overall, I think this is a win for Charlie Day because he does come off with the funniest moments and is the most memorable out of the main three. And really, you kind of forget about the annoying parts a little bit and just remember that he had some really funny stuff. Next up is Jason Bateman, who is playing Jason Bateman. He's good. He's funny. He has a really fun little, like, side story plotline that I really enjoyed and thought they did well. But, I mean, it's Jason Bateman playing Jason Bateman. I like that he was the voice of reason, but in the end, I like that he's also just as stupid as the other two, whether he likes to admit it or not, because he goes along with him. Then Jason Sudeikis, I think, got the short end of the stick. He really isn't given anything to do, and he's not given any of the funny gags. He just is kind of there to spit out some fun little lines and tag along with his two pals. And then we have the new additions of Chris Pine and Christoph Waltz. Chris Pine has a major role, and I loved him in this movie. I have not really seen him in a comedic role like this, or in just like a fun, crazy, kooky role, but he nailed it. I thought he was great. I loved seeing him in something different. Overall, Chris Pine was a huge add to the film. Christoph Waltz, on the other hand, is a very one-dimensional, one-note villain. He's great as always, but he's hardly in the movie and isn't given basically anything to do. So Christoph Waltz, to me, was a little bit of a waste of a bad guy and a waste of a big talent. And then for our other side characters, we do have Kevin Spacey returning. Again, he was only in the movie very limited because he's in jail, spoiler alert, but he was given very funny lines, so I enjoyed it when Kevin Spacey popped up, thought he was funny, thought he was great. Jamie Foxx's character is back and is given, I think, a bit meatier of a role than in the first movie. He also has some really funny, fun moments, and Jamie Foxx just knocks his part out of the park, so I enjoy Jamie Foxx. But for me, out of all of the side characters, Jennifer Aniston definitely steals the show. And she might actually steal the show, period. Because I loved every moment Jennifer Aniston was on screen, I just like wished to have her there more. Because she is a side character, I wish she was in it even more. She's really hilarious. Her first time around in Horrible Bosses, I think, was to be like, hey, look at sweet Jennifer Aniston, don't feel sorry for her, she's a bad girl. This time they upped the ante, and it feels more natural, and she's really embracing what it is they're asking her to do. I think her character is hilarious and the funniest part of the entire film. But that's just it. I laughed quite a bit through Horrible Bosses 2. It was a pretty continued meter of laughter, and that always signals successful comedy to me. I just thought it was good, raunchy, all fun, and I really enjoyed Horrible Bosses 2. But there are quite a bit of negatives for a movie I enjoyed so much. The first negative is the plot. I mean, it is what they say it is. It is another comedy that basically uses the first plot line, zhuzhes it up a little bit so that we don't recognize it, and then tries to present it to us as new. This is very similar to the plot of Horrible Bosses. The writing is very meh, the storyline is very meh, and everything outside of what the actors contribute and the actual comedic lines is very meh. There's a twist that's supposed to get you, but it's very predictable. You can see it coming from a mile away. And while I found the movie overall to be funny, there are some definite gags that fell really flat to me. There's a gag about like a pretend blowjob that I just thought was completely gratuitous and ridiculous. And then there's a joke, a rape joke in the movie that I thought could have definitely been left out. I know they put it in there for a plot point, and that disturbs me a little bit, and I just don't think you need to put a rape joke in any movie, so I wish they hadn't done that. But overall, I know maybe it'd be a guilty pleasure, but I actually really enjoyed Horrible Bosses 2, so I definitely recommend it. If you are a fan of the first one, go see this one. I think you'll love it. If you're just looking for a good comedy, I think this is one of the best options out there right now. Definitely better than that other sequel, Dumb and Dumber 2, that just came out, so choose this one. And I know I say I don't like dumb humor, but something about this just works for me, and I think it's the characters. They mesh so well, the vibe of the movie is so great, that you're just on for the ride and having a good time while you're there. So, definitely go out and see Horrible Bosses 2 for a good laugh. Oh, that has been my review of Horrible Bosses 2. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, go ahead, click like down below, subscribe to the channel, and have you seen Horrible Bosses 2? Are you looking forward to it? Comment down below, join the conversation. I love you all so much for your support. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!